What's going on, Workforce? Brian here, and today I'm actually going to walk you through the steps that I took to be able to play Lost Ark over in Korea, obviously here at the comfort of my own home in the United States. Several have asked for me to go ahead and put this guide together, and so I wanted to just compile my thoughts, kind of walk you through my process, and share with you everything that you need to know so that if you decide to make this jump and play, that you will hopefully be safe and that your account will be protected and that you can enjoy the game until we finally get some word, hopefully some point, on a North American release of this game officially. Now, you're going to have to purchase an account for this game, and all the links will be in the description below. So there's several things you need. A, you need to buy an account. B, you're gonna need some kind of VPN client. We're gonna recommend ExitLag. We partner with them. You can save 20% off using the link below, the code DOWORK. For that, you get 3 free days if you just want to try it out and see if it actually is going to work for you. But that's something you're going to need, whether it's ExitLag or another VPN product, because you're going to have to look like you're coming from Korea. And you're also going to need a Korean account. So we're going to recommend also the $28 account because this has been phone verified. Now, if you know somebody in Korea, give them a call, ask them to help set you up an account, and you'll be good to go. You can save $28 for however you've had that relationship. Awesome. I don't know anybody in Korea that I'm aware of. So anyway, just wanted to let you know. We've gone to newgameway.com. I haven't had any problems using the site. Typically, we definitely don't recommend it. It's against the terms of service. We do not recommend buying gold on all the various things when it comes to games. But this game isn't available, and I thought it was an interesting thing to try out, and I have been very pleased with the game so far. But note, start here. Or you can go to another site, but I haven't had any problems. It was fast, easy, worked, not sponsored by New Gameway at all, but I just wanted to bring that up first. Now, once you have an account, you need to set up and configure your VPN. Now, you can see here, you're gonna do two things. I've configured Stove, and I've got that set to the KR download, and I've also got Lost Ark, and I've got that configured here as well to go to KR Sewell 1 in this case. So that is how whenever I connect to these services and these games, the system is literally thinking that I'm coming from Korea, which helps a lot because if I actually go into Stove, I now see the games here on the left-hand side. You can actually go and download the game. You do not have to connect to ExitLag right away. You're just not gonna see any of the games listed over here on the left-hand side. So to download the software, the link is in the description. And if you're using Chrome, it will do a translate. It's got the download link, and it's going to allow you to do the client download. This actually installs Stove on your computer, not Lost Ark. So that's when you have to connect to the VPN, having Stove launched, and you're gonna see this option. Now, if the button is blue, it means the game is patched and ready for you, but in this case, I haven't updated it yet. So I'm gonna click on the orange button, and it's going to go ahead and start the download. You wanna be connected to your VPN, otherwise I think they'll be able to detect it, and you might end up getting your account banned. And with the game installed and updated, with the blue button, go ahead and click on it and launch the game for the first time. Now, after you've launched the game for the first time and it's up to date, you can now actually use the English patch. So what you're going to want to do here, though, is the link is in the description. You can go and download it. Now, this is made from Russians, and I don't know what might be happening. So just be warned whenever you download anything off the internet. Haven't had any problems with the computer or the application. It's going to show you a screen like this. If I say human and machine English, this is going to be really simple to play, but what it's going to do is it's going to go pretty much up patch the game. Now from here, you launch Lost Ark. Again, if this is orange, don't do this. let this get ready, and then you can apply it right here. Also, make sure this is checked, restore the original on close. That way, whenever you do close out of the English patch, whenever you do exit the game, it's going to restore Lost Ark to the way it was, thus helping to reduce the risk of you getting your account banned. So if you go ahead and play the game, it's actually going to launch Lost Ark, and let's go ahead and show you how that looks and how it plays with the English patch. So you can see here, I'm presented the various server names, which are in Korean, but I know I can actually click the enter button, and it's going to launch me into the game. Here, I need to pick my character, in which that I've got Brins, and I can go ahead and say start game with him, and it's going to prompt me for another password. This is going to be the password that they gave you in your account. So you have your password to log into the Stove, but when you come in and select your character, it's going to give you a different password. You can change this, by the way, just for future reference, and I'm going to go enter in my password so you can't see it. And so with that, you are now going to be playing and hopefully enjoying Lost Ark. There's a lot that this game has to offer, and the English patch, especially if you don't speak Korean, is very handy. I play with a controller. We put out a controller guide if you're interested in playing this game with a controller whatsoever. Very comfortable. I really am hopefully very excited that this game will come out to North America at some point this year. Now, I say all that just to remind you that you need to purchase an account. You need to use a VPN. Again, we recommend ExitLag, and you can use that. It will support the channel and hopefully give you a discount if you do decide to sign up for it. The game is free, so beyond buying your account, which is against the terms of service, which essentially could means that they could take it away if you end up, you know, getting caught. So is this worthwhile? It's only really you can answer that. I wouldn't necessarily think it would be for just somebody who has a curiosity for this game. So if there is that curiosity, you can always buy a smaller, you know, type account. You can always use the 3 free days of ExitLag and go from there. But I say all that to say then you make sure you download the game using the links below. After you patch the game, after obviously running on VPN, then download the English patch and run that. From there, let me know if you have any questions. Let me know if you have any concerns. And let me know what you end up playing and enjoying. I'm looking forward to talking to you guys more about Lost Ark, and maybe we'll hear about it soon. One can only hope. So anyway, for Work to Game, my name is Brian. Thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I'll talk to you soon. Take care.
Hey guys, it's me, Brian. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you're new here, we hope you hit that subscribe button. Check us out. We talk a lot about video games, and we hope to at least hear from you in the comments below. We also try to respond to our comments. You know, we really appreciate the comments, the discussion, all the various points of view that everybody is so kindly, impolitely or impolitely shares with us from time to time. So anyway, guys, again, thanks for watching this video. We hope you hit that like button. We hope you hit that subscribe button. Come back for more content each and every day. We post a lot around here, and we'd love to hear from you about what you like about video games and everything, and especially if you have any questions that you're stuck on in anything. So anyway, signing off. See you next time.